Hello, everyone. My name is Joseph, and we are here at the American Civil War Museum. Welcome to our new Homefront Education series, which we have designed specifically for all of you folks learning right at home. Now, since a lot of us are unable to go to school or see our friends and teachers, we here at the American Civil War Museum are working hard to bring our museum and its stories right to you. So let's get started. The Civil War is filled with the stories of people we now know well, from Frederick Douglass to Abraham Lincoln, even to Jefferson Davis. These are all famous names and faces we associate with the war, but they weren't always well known. Before they were the big names we know today, they were real people with hopes, loves, dreams, and fears, just like us. None more so than Harriet Tubman. Before She Was Harriet, by Lesa Cline-Ransome, illustrated by James E. Ransome. Here she sits, an old woman, tired and worn, her legs stiff, her back achy. But before wrinkles formed and her eyes failed, before she reached her twilight years, she could walk for miles and see clearly under a sky lit only with stars. Before she was an old woman, she was a suffragist, a voice for women who had none, in marriages, in courts, in voting booths. Before her voice grew soft and raspy, it was loud and angry, rising above injustice. Before she was a suffragist, she was General Tubman, rising out of the fog, armed with the courage strong in the face of rebels and planters and overseers as they watched fields burn and bridges fall, and 700 slaves stopped chopping and started running to a woman who ferried them to freedom on the Combahee River turned River Jordan. Before she was General Tubman, she was a Union spy, carrying secrets across battlefields to soldiers fighting in the Civil War for President Lincoln to end slavery. Before she was a Union spy, she was a nurse, caring for those hit with bullets and hatred and fear, tending to them with bandages and words in the bloody dirt of Southern soil. Before she was a nurse, she was Aunt Harriet, daughter of Ben and Rit, who helped her parents flee their master and find their way through woods and streams to the safety of Canada and to a new home in the North. Before she was Aunt Harriet, she was Moses, a conductor on the Underground Railroad with no trains and no tracks, just passengers traveling to freedom up north. Through swamps, past slave catchers, across rivers, under the cover of night. Seeking the promised land for her people, led by dreams and God and faith, a wisp of a woman with the courage of a lion. Before she was Moses, she was Minty of Maryland, of one slave owner, then others, who worked her, punished her with lashes, broke her back, but not her spirit. Before she was Minty, she was Araminta, a young girl taught by her father to read the woods and the stars at night, readying for the day she'd leave behind slavery, along with her name, and pick a new one, Harriet.
remember her days as a suffragist, as a general, as a spy, as a nurse, as Aunt Harriet, as Moses, as a conductor, as Minty, as Araminta, who dreamed of living long enough to one day be old and stiff and achy, tired and worn and wrinkled and free. To the guiding force of all the women who have led the way through courage, strength, perseverance, and intellect, Harriet Tubman, Sojourner Truth, Fannie Lou Hamer, Toni Morrison, Michelle Obama, Viola Davis, Ann Snead, Ernestine Cline. To all the black women who have carried the weight of family and work with grace and dignity.
Harriet Tubman's experiences helped her to become the person that we know today, and her journey is a lot like all of ours. In fact, I bet if you asked any adult you know how they got to where they are today, well, they'd have a story to tell you. Go ahead, try it. Talk to an older person in your life, maybe a grandparent, and ask them about their journey to where they are today. You'll find out more about that person, and you'll be doing the same kind of work that historians do, interviewing living people to find out more about the past. Now make sure to record your interview. Write notes in a journal, record a video, or if you're feeling really creative, we've even made a comic strip that you can fill out with pictures of your person's journey. Just check the link on our Homefront Education page to print out your copy. Now, when you're done, and with the permission of the person you've interviewed, send us a copy of their journey to education@acwm.org. As always, we'll choose our favorites to go up on our website. But thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again next time.